Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. In this video, we're going to talk about the differences between Hubstaff and Tsheets. All right, so similar to the Time Doctor video we made a while back, we're going to break down things like cost, features, and ease of use to help you decide which tool might be best for you. Let's get right into it. Hubstaff offers desktop, web, and mobile apps on almost every operating system available, while Tsheets offers a web-based solution but doesn't provide a downloadable app for your desktop, meaning you won't be able to track things offline. Now, that being said, Tsheets does provide a mobile app, and that's available on both iOS as well as Android. Hubstaff offers a bit more flexibility here since it can be downloaded as an app directly on your desktop, and that allows you to have access to key features like automated time tracking and productivity monitoring. Another major benefit is that you can track time while offline, and that data will be stored on your desktop until you're connected again. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the different plans and pricing options available for both apps. We'll start with Hubstaff's free plan, which is a great option for freelancers looking for all the basic features they need to track time to their projects. Next, we have the basic plan, which is $7 a user per month. And our basic plan includes all of the features shown in the free option with some additional features to support small to medium-sized teams. Following the basic plan, we have the premium plan, which is $10 a user per month. And this plan is designed to support data-driven growing organizations by allowing them to automate the more repetitive business processes so they can spend that time on more important tasks. And finally, we have the enterprise plan coming in at $20 a user per month. And this option will provide you with all of the features of the premium plan, but with a few extra benefits for even larger teams. One of the biggest differentiators here is going to be the support experience. We provide all of our customers with the quality support they need, but with the enterprise plan, not only will we help you set up your account properly, but your support tickets will also be moved higher up in our queue of requests, which means you can expect faster response times. Now let's take a look at Tsheets, and you'll see that pricing is actually pretty straightforward because there's only two options. And you'll also notice they don't offer a free plan. Their base level pricing is for the premium option, which starts at $8 a user per month, and there's an additional $20 a month as a base fee added on top of that. Tsheets' second option is their elite plan, which is $10 a user per month, with a monthly base fee that jumps up to $40. And you'll see there are five key features that separate the elite plan from the premium plan. There are two key points of consideration here when you're deciding which option is best for you. Number one, Hubstaff offers four plans in comparison to Tsheets' two plans, which means you have more flexibility regarding features and the size of your business. There's no need to pay for features you're not planning on using. And number two, there are some pretty big price differences. For example, Hubstaff doesn't include a base fee, and you can actually save on each plan if you decide to pay annually. Finally, let's review each app's interface. Hubstaff's desktop app is easy to use and intuitive. You simply select the project you want to track time to and click Start. In your browser, you'll find an organized layout with your main menu over on the left-hand side. And you can also customize your dashboard view so you can get a quick overview of the information that's most important to you. And the mobile interface is consistent with everything else. It's a straightforward, modern layout where you can start tracking time or access reports or timesheets on the go. And like I said earlier, there is no downloadable desktop app for Tsheets, so we'll be looking at the browser layout specifically. And you'll see that everything's clean and organized with the menu on the left. It's easy enough to navigate, and they do provide you with a Getting Started tab to help you navigate through the options. The one thing you'll notice right away, though, is that there isn't a dashboard for you to organize an overview of the information you're logging. Also, something else that's very interesting is that some of the menu options open up different windows, but they don't take you to a separate page. So, for example, if you want to see who's working, you're going to have to open up a search window instead of opening up a separate page. And the same thing goes for tracking time. You'll have to open up a separate window. It's not a huge deal, but it does make the workflow feel just a little less smooth. And here's a look at the mobile interface as well, and it actually feels a little more modern in comparison to the browser option. A cool feature for the mobile app is you'll be able to receive notifications anytime there's a change to someone's schedule. And similar to Hubstaff's mobile app, T-Sheets will give you location-based data when team members are clocked in, and it will also prompt them to clock in when they enter a specific job site. However, Hubstaff takes it one step further by allowing time tracking to start automatically whenever someone enters or leaves a job site. These additional automated features make it so there's less for your team to remember, and it can also help with timesheet accuracy. So let's round this video out with some final thoughts on each app. Hubstaff offers a little more flexibility to accommodate businesses of all sizes, from solo freelancers to large mobile fleets. There are also plenty of great productivity-focused features, things that allow you to see apps used or activity levels. And finally, Hubstaff also offers the GPS tracking features that are most useful to field teams. T-Sheets is also a good option for field teams, and it also naturally complements QuickBooks very well if that's a tool that's critical to your workflow. The biggest downside to T-Sheets might be the lack of a free plan and the additional base fees added on top of what you're paying each month. And there we have it. There's a brief breakdown of the differences between Hubstaff and T-Sheets. If you're looking for other alternatives to T-Sheets, I'll have a blog post linked right down below the video in the description, so feel free to check that out. And as always, thank you so much for watching, and we'll talk to you next time.